Hi, I'm Melody Bowler, speaking on behalf of Kevin Boyd, who wrote our article on disaster relief. Both at home and abroad, government is the major provider of disaster relief. But what's their track record? And might there be a better system to help those most in need of relief? Recall Hurricane Katrina. The city had an evacuation plan for those without cars, but it fell apart very quickly. There weren't enough buses for those who wanted to leave, yet district school buses were left idle to flood in the storm. Provisions for evacuating patients out of nursing homes completely fell apart, so many patients were killed in the storm and its aftermath. FEMA, the Federal Emergency Management Agency, housed the homeless in trailers, but many had toxic levels of formaldehyde in them. Once the storm had passed, even the recovery process was an absolute nightmare, bogged down in red tape. The government program, Road Home, was intended to give grants to those who wanted to fix up their homes or buy out those who wanted to leave, but it was run as a crony capitalist scheme. The company contracted to run the program, ICF International, spent $912 million of taxpayer-funded relief aid on overhead. Many homeowners didn't have their cases resolved for years. The government's handling of Katrina was a mess and a tragedy, teaching the residents of Louisiana to neither wait for nor trust the government's help. When disaster struck Louisiana again, residents helped each other instead. In August, a severe tropical rainstorm sat over Baton Rouge and dropped so much rain that homes and entire towns that had never flooded before were destroyed. 13 people were killed, with damage estimated at $8.7 billion. People found themselves trapped in their homes. They called 911, but the local and parish first responders were unable to cope with the magnitude of the situation and often didn't have the resources to respond. But a flotilla of private boats, which came to be known as the Cajun Navy, was able to step up and respond to help their neighbors. Supporting this ad hoc rescue effort was a volunteer network powered by modern technology. If someone needed to be rescued, they would go into a Facebook group and request pickup. The Cajun Navy also monitored police and other first responder radio bands. Instead of waiting on the Red Cross and the state government to establish shelters, local volunteers went to work themselves. Churches and Louisiana's largest film studio were converted into emergency shelters. Walmart proved to be a miracle worker. The corporation had its on-staff meteorologists give constant weather updates to determine where trucks needed to be. The company was able to shift deliveries from nearby distribution centers and stores to the disaster area and prioritize deliveries of important products like water and baby formula. The lesson out of Louisiana is that the private sector can provide immediate disaster relief in a timelier manner than the government can. In most cases, all that's needed to empower ordinary people is keeping government out of the way. When government expands, it crowds out civil society and the private sector. This can be a problem, especially in a disaster. If you liked this video, please click the link on your right to read the full article on our website, subscribe to us on YouTube, like us on Facebook, and follow us on Twitter. Thanks for watching.